पांडे अपनी उद्घोषिका साथी अश्विनी के साथ निदेशक सरदार वल्लभ भाई राष्ट्रीय पटेल पुलिस अकादमी की ओर से परेड मैदान में हार्दिक अभिनंदन करती हूँ।
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. On the occasion of the passing out parade of 73 RR batch, I, Sub-Inspector Ashwini, with my co-commentator, Ms. Anuradha Pandey, on behalf of the Director, Sardar Vallabhai Patel, National Police Academy, extend a warm welcome to our honorable guest, foreign dignitaries, senior officials, faculty members of the Academy, staff members of the Academy, and their families, and esteemed members of the electronic media. The 143 probationers of 73 RR basic course are about to begin the passing out parade from the main gate of the fort wall.
आज की इस परेड का अपना एक अलग महत्व है, अपनी एक गरिमा है। इसीलिए आप सब से हमारा अनुरोध है कि कृपया अपना मोबाइल फोन स्विच ऑफ कर दें अथवा साइलेंट मोड में कर दें। भारतीय पुलिस सेवा के परिवीक्षाधीन अधिकारियों की 73वीं दीक्षांत परेड किले की दीवार के पीछे खड़ी है और मैदान में प्रवेश करने के लिए तैयार है।
Bugler have just sounded the marker call.
भारतीय पुलिस सेवा के 73वें बैच के परिवीक्षाधीन अधिकारियों से सुसज्जित भव्य परेड किले के द्वार से मैदान में प्रवेश करती हुई। दर्शकों से अनुरोध है कि परेड के मैदान में स्थान ग्रहण करते ही जोरदार तालियां बजाकर परेड का हौसला अफजाई करें।
Thank you.
देवियों और सज्जनों, आज के इस दीक्षांत परेड में कुल 143 परिवीक्षाधीन अधिकारी भाग ले रहे हैं, जिनमें 31 महिला अधिकारी शामिल हैं। साथ ही 6 मालदीव्स पुलिस अधिकारी, 6 रॉयल भूटान पुलिस अधिकारी और 5 नेपाल पुलिस अधिकारी सम्मिलित हैं। आज की इस भव्य दीक्षांत परेड का नेतृत्व कर रही हैं पंजाब काडर की परिवीक्षाधीन अधिकारी सुश्री दर्पण अहलुवालिया। प्लाटून 1 का नेतृत्व कर रहे हैं पश्चिम बंगाल काडर के परिवीक्षाधीन अधिकारी श्री संभव जैन। प्लाटून 2 का नेतृत्व कर रहे हैं नेपाल पुलिस के परिवीक्षाधीन अधिकारी श्री किरण रावत। प्लाटून 3 का नेतृत्व कर रही हैं रॉयल भूटान पुलिस की परिवीक्षाधीन अधिकारी लेफ्टिनेंट डेमा। प्लाटून 4 का नेतृत्व कर रहे हैं नेपाल पुलिस के परिवीक्षाधीन अधिकारी श्री अनिल थापा। प्लाटून 5 का नेतृत्व कर रहे हैं पश्चिम बंगाल काडर के परिवीक्षाधीन अधिकारी श्री जॉर्ज एलन जॉन। प्लाटून 6 का नेतृत्व कर रहे हैं रॉयल भूटान पुलिस के परिवीक्षाधीन अधिकारी लेफ्टिनेंट पेमा दोर्जी। आप देख सकते हैं अश्वरोही दल, जो कि आज की इस परेड में 4 चांद लगा रहे हैं, और इस दल का नेतृत्व कर रहे हैं परिवीक्षाधीन अधिकारी मालदीव पुलिस के मोहम्मद सामी। आपके सामने प्रस्तुत है भव्य बैंड। भव्य बैंड प्लाटून का नेतृत्व कर रहे हैं अकादमी के बैंड मास्टर श्री उका राम। इस बैंड में सम्मिलित हैं आरपीएफ ब्रास बैंड मौलाली, सीआरपी ब्रास बैंड चंद्रायन गुट्टा, एसबीपी एनपीए ब्रास बैंड हैदराबाद।
Ladies and gentlemen, I invite your attention towards the fourth wall on the insignias of the state and central police organizations. The respective flags of these formations can also be seen fluttering in the breeze over these insignias. From the center of the fourth wall gate towards the left, the first flag is of National Police Academy, followed by Jharkhand, BSF, ITBP, Nagaland, West Bengal, Chandigarh, Nepa, Goa, Tripura, Delhi, SPG, Sikkim, RPF, Jammu and Kashmir, CRPF, Kerala, CISF, SSB, NSG, Chhattisgarh, Himachal Pradesh, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Uttarakhand and Meghalaya. From the center of the fourth wall gate towards the right, the first flag is of Arunachal Pradesh, followed by Lakshadweep, Puducherry, Maharashtra, Gujarat, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Bihar, Odisha, Rajasthan, Punjab, Telangana, Mizoram, Assam, Indian Police Service, Manipur, Dadar Nagar Haveli, Daman and Diu, and Andaman and Nicobar.
दर्शकों से अनुरोध है कि निशान के परेड मैदान में प्रवेश करते ही निशान के सम्मान में अपने स्थान पर खड़े हो जाएं तथा वर्दीधारी सैल्यूट करें। निशान टोली का नेतृत्व संभाले हुए हैं निरीक्षक श्री अजय कुमार सेनापति और निशान को थामे हुए हैं निरीक्षक श्री अनिल शर्मा। निशान टोली के रक्षक हैं एडीआई नवीन, एडीआई सुरेश, एडीआई मोहम्मद अनवर, एडीआई मधु और इस निशान टोली के साथ संगत कर रहे हैं 12th बटालियन पाइप बैंड नलगोंडा।
In a short while from now, Director of the Academy, Shri Atul Karwal, will be amongst us. The National Police Academy was established on 15th September 1948. To train new entrants to the Indian Police Service and to organize in-service training for all levels of the service. In recognition of the outstanding achievements of the Academy and its services to the nation, the President of India's Colour was awarded to the Academy on 15th September 1988. So far, 72 batches of IPS probationers have passed through the portal of this institution, and also a large number of officers of the state and central police organizations and foreign police forces. Ladies and gentlemen, Director of the Academy, Shri Atul Karwal has arrived. Let's extend a very warm welcome to him.
कुछ ही क्षणों में आज की दीक्षांत परेड के मुख्य अतिथि भारत के राष्ट्रीय सुरक्षा सलाहकार माननीय श्री अजित डोवाल जी यहां पधारेंगे।
Shri Atul Karwal is an IPS officer of 1988 batch, born on Gujarat cadre. He has completed his master's in business administration. He has served as ASP and SP in many districts of Gujarat. He also served as assistant director outdoors in Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel National Police Academy, Hyderabad from the year 1998 to 2002. As IG CRPF Srinagar, he supervised 23 battalions of counter-terrorist operations and law and order. He was also IG training, IG and additional DG Pers, CRPF, before joining this academy. Shri Karwal was adjudged the best officer trainee of his batch during his basic training at this academy. Recognizing his dedication towards the service, he was awarded Police Medal for Gallantry and first Bar Police Medal for Gallantry in 2020, President's Police Medal for Distinguished Service in 2016, and Police Medal for Meritorious Service in 2010. He has also been decorated with the Kathin Seva Padak for his duties in Srinagar, Parakram Padak for an operation in Kashmir, Ati Utkrishta Seva Padak and Commendation Discs by Director SVP NPA, DG Jammu and Kashmir, and 5 discs from DGCRPF. He is an ultramarathoner and a triathlete. He has undergone 12 weeks of police commando course with National Security Guard in 1994. He won a silver medal in individual tent pegging in the All India Police Equestrian Meet in 1997. He is also a black belt holder in martial arts, as well trained in scuba diving and skydiving, and scaled Mount Everest in 2008 as a member of the Indian Police Mount Everest Expedition. At present, he is serving this prestigious academy as director since 27th December 2019.
हमें बेसब्री से मुख्य अतिथि महोदय के आगमन की प्रतीक्षा है। कुछ ही क्षणों में महोदय का आगमन होगा।
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your kind attention, please? The trotting of horses is indicating the arrival of our chief guest of the occasion. National Security Advisor of India, Shri Ajit Doval, Kirti Chakra.
इस दीक्षांत परेड के मुख्य अतिथि भारत के राष्ट्रीय सुरक्षा सलाहकार माननीय श्री अजित डोवाल जी हमारे बीच पधार चुके हैं और हम सब की ओर से अकादमी के परेड मैदान में आपका हार्दिक अभिनंदन करते हैं। सटीक एवं सधे हुए कदमों से हौसला आसमान की बुलंदियों को छूता हुआ सूर्य का तेज व मीठी सी मुस्कान के साथ मंच की ओर परेड कमांडर सुश्री दर्पण अहलुवालिया।
श्री अजित डोवाल ज्वाइंड द इंडियन पुलिस सर्विस इन 1968, बोर्न ऑन केरला कैडर। ही इज अ ग्रेजुएट ऑफ नेशनल डिफेंस कॉलेज एंड हैज कंप्लीटेड हिज पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन इन इकोनॉमिक्स फ्रॉम द यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ आगरा। इन 1972 ही ज्वाइंड द इंटेलिजेंस ब्यूरो अंडर द एनमार्किंग स्कीम। ड्यूरिंग दोज थ्री डिकेड्स ऑफ हिज सर्विस विद आईबी ही हेल्ड मेनी सीनियर पोजिशंस बोथ विद इन एंड आउटसाइड द कंट्री, which included tenures in Mizoram, Sikkim, Punjab, and Jammu and Kashmir. Shri Ajit Doval headed the IB's operations wing for over a decade, where he conducted several successful operations. He founded the Multi-Agency Center as a mechanism for sharing intelligence amongst all the stakeholders of an effective counter-intelligence and counter-terrorism response. He also served in Pakistan and UK for almost a decade. Shri Ajit Doval rose to become the director of IB. Post-retirement, Shri Ajit Doval remained actively involved in the discourse on national security in India. He was the founder director of Vivekananda International Foundation, a leading think tank in New Delhi, focusing on issues pertaining to national security and strategic studies.
Thank you.
Ajit Doval was elected as the president of the International Association of Chiefs of the Police for Asia and Pacific Region in 2004. At present, he is serving as the National Security Advisor to the Government of India since 30th May 2014. As the longest serving NSA, he has been overseeing the country's response to both internal and external security challenges at the critical geostrategic juncture. Sri Ajit Doval has been decorated with the Kirti Chakra in 1989, one of the highest defense gallantry awards of the country. He has the distinction of being the country's youngest IPS officer to be awarded the prestigious Indian Police Medal for meritorious service.
तिहत्तरवें बैच के भारतीय पुलिस सेवा के परिवीक्षाधीन अधिकारियों की दीक्षांत परेड का निरीक्षण करके मंच की ओर लौटते हुए माननीय श्री अजीत डोवाल जी, आपका आभार व्यक्त करते हुए हम पुनः मंच पर आपका हार्दिक अभिनंदन इन पंक्तियों के साथ करते हैं। तेजस्वी सम्मान खोजते नहीं गोत्र बतलाकर, तेजस्वी सम्मान खोजते नहीं गोत्र बतलाकर, पाते हैं जग में प्रशस्ति अपना कर्तव्य दिखलाकर। माननीय श्री अजीत डोवाल जी, आपका पुनः स्वागत है। कुछ ही क्षणों में राष्ट्रीय ध्वज टोली मैदान में प्रवेश करेगी। सभी दर्शकों से अनुरोध है कि राष्ट्रीय ध्वज के परेड मैदान में प्रवेश करते ही राष्ट्रीय ध्वज के सम्मान में अपने स्थान पर खड़े हो जाएं तथा वर्दीधारी सैल्यूट करें। देवियों और सज्जनों, राष्ट्रीय ध्वज टोली की कमान संभालने का अवसर मिला है निरीक्षक श्री सोमवीर को एवं अकादमी ध्वज को थामे हुए हैं निरीक्षक श्री परमवीर और इनके रक्षक हैं एडीआई जन्मेजॉय, एडीआई बासुमतारी, एडीआई शाहनवाज और एडीआई दिनेश। दीक्षांत परेड का ऐतिहासिक दिन, शपथ ग्रहण करते 73वें बैच के नवयुवा परिवीक्षाधीन अधिकारी। धन्य है वो माँ, वो पिता, वो गुरु, वो विद्यालय प्रांगण जिसने ऐसे सपूत और सुपुत्रियां राष्ट्र की सेवा में अर्पित किया, जिसने तन मन धन से मातृभूमि को अपनी सेवाएं प्रदान करने का संकल्प लिया। भारत की स्वतंत्रता और आत्मनिर्भरता का प्रतीक है तिरंगा झंडा। केसरिया, सफेद और हरा, इन तीनों रंगों के मेल से बना तिरंगा प्रतीक है हमारी खुशहाली का, धैर्य का, शौर्य का, बलिदान का, सत्य का, शुद्धता का, विश्वास का और मैत्रीपूर्ण संबंधों का। शपथ ग्रहण का ये पावन दिन परिवीक्षाधीन अधिकारियों के जीवन में मील का पत्थर है, एक पुण्य पथ है, एक अविरल पायदान है। भारतीय पुलिस सेवा में पड़ने वाले कदम एक नए विहान की भांति, एक नई जिम्मेदारी, नए कर्तव्यों और नए उत्तरदायित्वों का अनुभव कराएगी। कठिन प्रशिक्षण के ये दिन जीवन भर याद आएंगे और आज ली हुई शपथ, जीवन में कोई भी कार्य करने से पूर्व हमें अपने कर्तव्यों के प्रति जागृत बनाएंगे। शपथ ग्रहण का ये पावन और ऐतिहासिक दिन, ये शपथ है तिरंगे के प्रति, ये शपथ है राष्ट्र के प्रति, ये शपथ है समाज के प्रति, ये शपथ है संस्थान के प्रति, अपने परिजनों के सम्मान के प्रति और अपने स्वाभिमान के प्रति। ये शपथ है निष्ठा का, ईमानदारी का, न्याय का और संवेदी पुलिस के रूप में एक कुशल प्रशासक का। आज की इस परेड को देखते हुए कवि की पंक्तियां याद आ रही हैं, जो भरा नहीं है भावों से, जिसमें बहती रसधार नहीं, वह हृदय नहीं है पत्थर है, जिसमें स्वदेश का प्यार नहीं, जिसमें स्वदेश का प्यार नहीं।
Ladies and gentlemen, the eminent opportunity of carrying the national flag is given to Inspector DI Somveer, and Inspector DI Paramveer is carrying the Academy's flag. The Indian national flag represents the hopes and aspirations of the people of India. It is the symbol of our national pride. Over the last few decades, several people, including members of the armed forces, have unselfishly laid down their lives to keep the tricolor flying in its full glory. A thoughtful mind, when it sees a nation's flag, sees not the flag only, but the nation itself, and whatever may be its symbol, its insignia, he reads essentially the flag, the government, the principles, the truth, and the history which belongs to the nation that sets it forth. If I were asked, under what sky the human mind has most fully developed some of its choicest gifts, has most deeply pondered on the greatest problems of life, and has found solutions, I should point to India and its people. The ceremonial touching of the national flag by the IPS probationers is a precursor to the oath of allegiance to the Constitution of India that the IPS probationers will be taking today. The greatest glory in living lies not in falling, but in rising every time we fall. These young officers will dedicate themselves in the service of the nation and pledge to serve the people as per the ideals of the police service, ensuring justice for all without fear or favor. Now, Director of the Academy, Shri Atul Karwal, will administer the oath to the IPS probationers of 73 RR batch.
मैं शपथ लेता हूं कि मैं भारत के संविधान के प्रति एवं भारतीय पुलिस के आदर्शों के प्रति सच्ची श्रद्धा और निष्ठा रखूंगा। मैं भय या पक्षपात, अनुराग या द्वेष के बिना सभी प्रकार के लोगों के प्रति न्यायपूर्वक व्यवहार करते हुए अपने कर्तव्यों का निर्वहन करूंगा।
The national flag is about to leave the parade ground. All the spectators are requested to stand in their places when the national anthem will be played as a mark of respect to the national flag when it leaves the parade ground, and officers in uniform shall salute.
कदम कदम बढ़ाए जा, खुशी के गीत गाए जा, ये जिंदगी है कौम की, तू कौम पर लुटाए जा। देवियों और सज्जनों, ये वही पंक्तियां हैं जो आजाद हिंद के फौज के सैनिकों को प्रेरित करने के लिए, उनमें जोश का संचार करने के लिए गाई गई थी। बैंड की मधुर धुन पर मार्च करती हुई 73वें बैच के भारतीय पुलिस सेवा के परिवीक्षाधीन अधिकारियों की 6 टुकड़ियां कदम से कदम तथा हाथ से हाथ मिलाकर तेज चाल में आगे बढ़ते 73वें बैच के नवयुवा परिवीक्षाधीन अधिकारी।
Ladies and gentlemen, this parade contingent consists of 143 probationers, which includes 6 officers from Maldives Police, 6 officers from Royal Bhutan Police, and 5 officers from Nepal Police. And this prestigious parade is being commanded by Ms. Darpan Aluwalia of Punjab Cadre. She is the proud winner of the Martyr KS Vyas Trophy for Internal Security and Public Order and Field Crafts and Tactics. Platoon number 1 is commanded by Shri Sambhav Jain of West Bengal Cadre. He is the winner of the SRB Cup for Drill. Platoon number 2 is being commanded by Shri Kiran Rawat of Nepal Police Service. He is the winner of the Jaipur Cup for Physical Training Gentlemen. Platoon number 3 is commanded by Lieutenant Dema of Royal Bhutan Police. She is the winner of the 1958 Batch IPS Officers Trophy for the Best Lady Outdoor Probationer. The prestigious Nishantoli is being commanded by Inspector DI Ajay Kumar Senapati, and Nishan is being carried by Inspector DI Anil Sharma. Platoon number 4 is commanded by Shri Anil Thapa of Nepal Police Service. He is the winner of the BSF Trophy for Proficiency in Outdoor Subjects. Platoon number 5 is commanded by Shri George Allen John of West Bengal Cadre. He is the winner of the Mehta Cup for Studies. Platoon number 6 is commanded by Lieutenant Pema Dorji of Royal Bhutan Police. He is the winner of the Tong Cup for Equitation. And the mounted platoon is being commanded by Shri Mohammed Sami of Maldives Police. Ladies and gentlemen, the band is bringing up every moment alive. The synchronized marching of the troops is revealing the actual meaning of uniform and uniformity. The academy has trained these officers to be fearless in action and steadfast in deeds. Ambitious, courageous, determined, exuberant are these young officers marching confidently to the beats of drum, marching in unison, heralding a dawn of new era. These platoons consist of smartly dressed up, energetic, young and smart members of the Indian Police Service, marching with their morale high to the tune of band in perfect alignment.
46 सप्ताह के कड़े प्रशिक्षण के पश्चात 73वें बैच के भारतीय पुलिस सेवा के परिवीक्षाधीन अधिकारी आज दीक्षांत परेड के अवसर पर परेड मैदान में उपस्थित कड़ी खाकी वर्दी में सुसज्जित गर्व से उठे मस्तक परेड मैदान में प्रवेश के समय इनका आत्मविश्वास इन सब से अभिव्यक्ति मिल रही है इनके उस मानसिक और शारीरिक शक्ति की जिसके परिवर्धन का प्रयास अकादमी प्रशिक्षण के दौरान किया जाता है। इस दृढ़ता और आत्मविश्वास के साथ परेड मैदान में कदम मिलाकर चलना मानो हमें कह रहा हो वह खून कहो किस मतलब का जिसमें उबाल का नाम नहीं वह खून कहो किस मतलब का आ सके देश के काम नहीं वो खून कहो किस मतलब का जिसमें जीवन नरवानी हो जो परवश होकर बहता है वो खून नहीं है पानी है। राष्ट्रीय पुलिस अकादमी का मुख्य उद्देश्य भारतीय पुलिस के लिए एक ऐसा नेतृत्व प्रदान करना है जो साहस गर्व समर्पण और जनता के प्रति उत्कृष्ट सेवा भावना रखते हुए पुलिस बल को आगे बढ़ा सके तथा देश के उत्तरोत्तर में विकास में सहायक हो सके। परेड समीक्षा क्रम में आगे बढ़कर माननीय मुख्य अतिथि महोदय को सलामी देगी।
Now, Director of the Academy, Shri Atul Karwal is requested to present the report of 73 RR batch.
Honorable National Security Advisor, Shri Ajit Doval, honored guests, delegates from our friendly countries, Nepal and Maldives, members of the NPA team, Parade Commander, Ms. Darpan Aluwalia, and officer trainees on parade. My congratulations to Ms. Darpan Aluwalia, who has stood first in phase one training and is commanding the passing out parade today. We are privileged and honored to have with us the National Security Advisor, Shri Ajit Doval, as the chief guest for this parade. On behalf of the Academy, I extend a very hearty welcome to you, sir. ...132 officer trainees of the 73rd RR of Indian Police Service and 17 foreign police officers from Bhutan, Maldives and Nepal have completed 46 weeks of phase 1 training and are passing out today. This batch joined the Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel National Police Academy on 28 December 2020. The training time is almost equally divided between indoor and outdoor training. In indoor training, they learnt about laws of the land, skills of scientific investigation, forensic science and forensic medicine, criminology and police management in India, attitudes, ethics and human rights, internal security and public order, and information and communication technology. A physically demanding outdoor training included physical fitness, drill, weapon training, shooting skills, horse riding, swimming, driving, unarmed combat, navigation skills, and planning and conduct of operations. The officer trainees have completed a 16-kilometer run and a 40-kilometer route march in a timed manner. They also learned various sports and athletic events. The officer trainees underwent attachments with the Greyhounds of Telangana Police, with BSF at the Central School of Weapons and Tactics, and with in the left-wing extremism areas of Chhattisgarh and Jharkhand. They also had an election attachment in West Bengal, Assam, Tamil Nadu and Kerala to observe and learn about the election arrangements. Imparting skills and knowledge, the Academy has tried its best to build upon the values of courage, integrity, compassion, teamwork and humility in the officers. I am confident that they will prove to be officers with high standards of professionalism. The officer trainees on parade are at the threshold of their challenging careers. Dikshant parade is a memorable and once-in-a-lifetime occasion for them. I again thank the chief guest for gracing this occasion. I also thank the other distinguished guests, delegates from Nepal and Maldives, ex-directors of the Academy, families and members of the media for being a part of this occasion. I also thank the large number of ex-faculty members, service colleagues, family members, friends and well-wishers who are viewing this parade virtually. I am sure all of them are giving their best wishes to these young officers for leading a life that will make the Academy, the service and the nation proud of them. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir. Now cups and trophies will be awarded to the probationers of 73 RR batch for their outstanding performance during their basic course. May I now request Honorable Chief Guest Shri Ajit Doval to kindly present the cups and trophies to the winners. Ms. Darpan Aluwalia for Mata K.S. Vyas Trophy for Internal Security, Public Order and Field Crafts and Tactics. Ms. Darpan Aluwalia. Shri Kiran Rawat for the Jaipur Cup for Physical Gentlemen. Shri Kiran Rawat. Shri Sambhav Jain for the Special Recruitment Batch Cup for Drill, Shri Sambhav Jain. Lieutenant Pima Dorji for the Tong Cup for Equitation. Lieutenant Pima Dorji. Shri Anil Thapa for the BSF Trophy for Proficiency in Outdoor Subjects. Shri Anil Thapa. Ms. Simone Dittal for the Jaipur Cup for Physical Training, Ladies. Ms. Simone Dittal. Shri George Allen John for the Mehta Cup for Studies. Shri George Allen John. Lieutenant Dema for 1958 Batch IPS Officers Trophy for the Best Lady Outdoor Probationer. Lieutenant Dema. Lieutenant Pema Dorji for the IPS Association's Sword of Honor for the Best Outdoor Probationer, Lieutenant Pema Dorji. Thank you, sir.
अब हम आज के मुख्य अतिथि भारत के राष्ट्रीय सुरक्षा सलाहकार माननीय श्री अजित डोवाल जी से अनुरोध करते हैं कि 73वीं परिवीक्षाधीन अधिकारियों की दीक्षांत परेड को अपने आशीर्वचनों से आह्लादित करें। आपका स्वागत हम इन पंक्तियों के साथ करते हैं। श्रीमान, पढ़ो उसे जो झलक रहा है इनमें तेज प्रकाश, पढ़ो उसे जो झलक रहा है इनमें तेज प्रकाश, इनके रोम रोम में अंकित है इनका इतिहास। माननीय श्री अजित डोवाल जी,
डायरेक्टर ऑफ सरदार वल्लभ भाई पटेल नेशनल पुलिस एकेडमी श्री अतुल करवाल, फॉर्मर डायरेक्टर्स ऑफ दिस एकेडमी, retired and serving police officers present, foreign dignitaries, members of the faculty and training staff, media, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I feel honored and privileged to review this parade today of 132 officers of the 73rd batch of IPS officers. I am also delighted to see 17 foreign officers, trainees here who have given an excellent account of themselves, as is evident by the number of trophies that they won. I am grateful to Director Karwal for giving me this opportunity for being here amidst you. I am deeply impressed by the parade. Its turnout, its brisk movements, perfect synchronization, words of command, and very special compliments to the parade commander, Darpan Ahluwalia, who has brought a great pride to all of us. My compliments to all the members of this parade who have been excellently well and gave a great performance. But this is also an occasion to thank the trainers and the ustads who have converted you into such a good, coherent parade ground team to work so well. I think they have really worked very hard. On this solemn occasion, I congratulate all of you for what you have achieved and also felicitate for all that you are going to achieve hereafter. There is a great future beckoning you. All of you are going to be the forerunners of the future policing of this country and the destiny of this country. This is also a time for me to felicitate your families for having produced such bright young men and women who are going to serve this nation for many more decades ahead. 52 years back, I too passed out, and on this solemn occasion, let we all as IPS officers express our deep feeling of gratitude to our alma mater, the National Police Academy. It weaves us into a common identity, an identity that stays with you hereafter. You'll always be known as an IPS officer. Your name will be incomplete without that suffix. Even after you retire, you will be remembered and known as a retired IPS officer. So it's an identity that this academy brings us, gives to us, and brings us together as a family. It binds us. Together we are a team, we are together, we are a family which is dedicated to the service of this country. I am also beholden to the successive generations of the faculty members, ustads, and the trainers who shaped us into becoming these police officers. This academy has trained 5,700 officers since 1948. Many among them excelled, brought laurels and honor to the service and the nation. They were great names, and there was something much great that they've contributed that many of you would be knowing as you progress in your career. They were sources of inspirations for us. They led central and state forces and played a vital role in national building in post-independence period. They led brave men and women of about 21 lakh persons. That is the strength of our police forces in the strength in the states in the center. And 35,480 of them, those brave hearts, under their leadership, sacrificed their lives. They were the great leaders who were able to inspire and make people give the highest sacrifice. And that is the qualities of leadership that we expect from each one of you. We would also like to remember those 40 IPS officers who got martyred, who, like you and me, passed out from this academy. All of them played a seminal role in nation building, and you too have a great role ahead. You will all see 100th year of India's independence and beyond. It will be a different India at that time. India is on the march, and you will see that you will be leading these police forces at a time when it will be in India, which has got a new place in the international arena. It will be a country that will be known for its base, for its many achievements and many accomplishments. It will be one of the lead nations. What we have achieved in the last few years is a beckoner to the direction in which the country is moving. For you to really contribute your might, you have got to develop a national perspective. Don't forget that the first word of your service is the Indian Police Service. You are for India, and India is for you. Every other identity gets subsumed into this Indian identity. The interest of India should be supreme, and the constitution of India and the values, the traditions, the civilizations that this our family represents. My young colleagues, quintessence of democracy does not lie in the ballot box. It lies in the laws which are made by the people who are elected by, who are elected through those ballot boxes. You are the ones who are the enforcers of those laws. Laws are not as good as they are made. Laws are as good as they are executed and implemented, and the service that the people are able to get out of it. If you fail to implement and enforce them in the letter and spirit in which they were made, they were as bad or as good as they were made. So the success of democracy in enforcement of laws that are given by the, that is given by the people through their elected representative lies in your efficiency, in your commitment, in your values, in your attitudes, and in your performance on the ground. Their implementation is more important than their legislation. No nation can be built where rule of law has failed. People cannot feel safe and secure where law enforcers are weak, corrupt, partisan. I found that many of these values were enshrined in the oath that you just took. Enforce the law with that spirit. And it's no small call. Together, your service is going to provide, or my service also, to provide this sense of their being protected by law, a sense of safety, sense of security to 130 crore people. Every seventh man on this planet is the one whose safety and whose security you are responsible for. People are most important. The new frontiers of war, what we call the fourth generation warfare, is the civil society. Wars have ceased to become an effective instrument for achieving your political or military objectives. They are too expensive and unaffordable. And at the same time, there is an uncertainty about their outcome. But it is the civil society that can be subverted, that can be suborned, that can be divided, that can be manipulated to hurt the interest of a nation. And you are there to see that they stand fully protected. So the service of the people is the greatest service, not only from the point of view of our nation building, but also from the point of view of our national security. And police has to work closely with other organizations for which they require a mental attitude that together we are going to work together, together we are going to serve this nation. You are not only required to enforce the rule of law, I mean the civil society, you are also supposed to protect and maintain the order in the length and breadth of this country. In 32 lakh square kilometers of this country, there is not even an inch which is not part of a police station. Our sovereignty goes only as far as the last police station's jurisdiction goes, from the coastal areas to the border areas. In every part of it, maintaining peace and order is also your responsibility. So it is not only 130 crore human beings, but it's also 32 lakh square kilometers of land whose protection is your responsibility. Maybe in the borders, we have got other armed forces, we have got army, we have got others, but still, the peace and order continues to be the responsibility of the police. Your responsibilities in the year ahead will include not only the policing for which you, about which you have been trained very well, but it will extend. You will be responsible for border management of this country. 15,000 kilometers of the border, most of which has got this peculiar problems of its own, whether it's the border with Pakistan or China, or Myanmar or Bangladesh, we have got different types of security-related issues which are manned by the police and the central police organizations which are manning these borders. You will also be expected to undertake highly specialized investigations, maybe with the CBI, with the NIA, maybe with the cyber crime, maybe economic offenses and others, which I think you have got to train. And look at it as your career is not only confined to this thing, but always think big, prepare yourself, and train yourself. You will also, some of you would be also working for the intelligence, both within the country and outside. And you are the one who will be responsible to see that governments are able not only to take the informed decisions, the decisions which are based on some very important facts that need to be known, but also they are enforced, and they are enforced in a way that they can serve the people and the country's interest best. And technology is another frontier in which I think many of you will have to excel. And I am very sure that some of our very specialized police organizations, which are having the skill, state-of-the-art technologies for the service of the nation, you will be able to serve the upgrade the technological capabilities of the police force. These are all vital elements in nation building. You are leaving this academy not only as police leaders, but also as the soldiers of the new coming vibrant India. Without your success, this nation cannot succeed. If the internal security fails, no country can be great. If the people are not secure, people are not safe, they cannot rise to their potential, probably the country can never grow. You are a very lucky generation. You are going to see many momentous changes. A lot of hard and heavy lifting has been done by our predecessors when independence was fought. The country was economically weak. Country was more divided. There were princely states, there were problems of partition, and there were a series of other problems that they had to face. Probably now the new type of challenges have come. And I'm very sure and confident that all of you are very well equipped and mentally disposed to face those challenges. It is extremely important that you develop the right attitudes. And I'm very happy that the director lays so much an emphasis on the right attitudes. You cannot achieve unless you are able to have the right attitude, the right bent of mind, and the right way of training yourself and self-actualizing. You have got to have, wherever you go, you'll find there will be a lot of talk about reforms. Reforms is learning from the past and not doing the same mistakes again. I want the younger generations not only to be thinking of reforms, that is, you will not commit the mistakes that I did. You have got to be transformative. Now the police forces will have to bring about transformative, that is, think about the future and find the solutions today and bring about the change in the force and in your capabilities, keeping in view the coming challenges. Thank you very much, and once again my compliments to all of you, and thanks to the director.
आपके ये शब्द हमारे जीवन में मील का पत्थर बन सदैव प्रेरणा देते रहेंगे. आपका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद माननीय महोदय. परेड कमांडर परिवीक्षाधीन अधिकारी सुश्री दर्पण अहलुवालिया परेड को निष्क्रमण करने की अनुमति हेतु मंच की ओर अग्रसर. दर्शकों से अनुरोध है कि निशान के सम्मान में अपने स्थान पर खड़े हो जाएं तथा वर्दीधारी सैल्यूट करें.
Ladies and gentlemen, the peeling off has started. These young officers are about to take their first step in the service of the nation. We salute you, officers. Live a life of dignity, humility, and empathy. You should be men and women who shall weather many storms and still stand tall, very tall. Marching to the tune of Auld Lang Syne in perfect coordination, with their head held high and dreams in their eyes for a prosperous nation, are these young officers of 73 RR Basic Course. Coming in front of you, from left to right, are
Simon Dhital, Madhu Kumari, Vishakha Jain,
Shafkat Amna, Mehak Swami, Jasleen Kaur,
Sejal Agrawal, Pooja Gupta, Momal Raj Purohit,
Punmani N, Sweety Sharawat, Rashmita Rao,
Pooja Kumar, Swati Singh, J. Mahesh,
Sparsha Nilangi, Shivani Mehla, Sunakshi Saxena,
Shiva Singh, Jasroop Kaur, Chetan Zangmo,
Gokul Raj, Fateh Abdul Latif, Anukriti Sharma,
Abdul Hafiz Ibrahim, Sharat Aris, Deepti Garg,
Taposh Basumatari, Anurag Dwedi, Shruti Shivastava,
Shubhank Mishra, Sumit Kumar Agrawal, Paritosh Pankaj,
Vijay Bharat Reddy, Sameer Ahmed, Ayman Zamal,
Purpa Yeshi, Rishabh Garg, Vivekanand Shukla,
Girish Yadav, Pankaj Atulkar, Sunil Sharon,
Swapnil Pawar, Vaibhav Ramanlal, Rahul Gupta,
Jitendra Agarwal, K. Ramdas, Sheetal Kumar,
Kinley Pelzang, Farash, Shelke Nachiket,
Harshal Meena, Manush Parekh, Chandrasekhar R,
Sandeep Kumar Patil, Manish Bhartiya, Pankaj Kumar,
Sange Thinle, Sandeep Garai, Manish,
Avinash Bhimrao, Praveen Pushkar, Mayang Gurjar,
Arun Pavitran, Jagdish, Sankirt,
Pankaj Lamba, Nimish Patil, Raspreet Singh,
Prabhat Kumar, Raghupati, Vikas Kumar,
Randhir Kumar, Rahul Meena, Shivam Siddharth,
Ali Sharif, Stalin R, Rohit Verma,
Ashit Kamle, Shahul Hamid, Maurya Krishna,
Ayush Vikram Singh, Logesh Kumar, Robinson Gurya,
Sujit Shankar, Prabina P, Sunny Gupta,
Megha Swaroop, Abhishek Shivhare, Rishikesh Reddy,
Vikram Sihag, Nidhi Thakur, Balveer Singh,
Patil Kantilal Subhash, Shakti Mohan Awasthi, Nikhil Agarwal,
Satya Sai Kartik, Shivam Verma, Amit Kumawat,
Abhay Sinha Balasaheb, Shashank, Shubhash Kativoda,
Manish Chaudhary, Smritik Rajnala, Shri Ram,
Mayank Mishra, Nakul Deshmukh, Mohammad Nadimuddin,
Yash Pratap, Shrimal, Raghav Jain, Majid Iqbal Khan,
Mithun, Harisha, Dheeraj Kunnubili,
Punit Duvedi, Alok Kumar, Shweta K,
Kurukunda Siddharth, Shias KM, Nikhil Rakecha,
Chirag Jain, Deepak Zaveria, Gaurav Tyagi,
Tegbir Singh Sandhu, Krishna Kumar Singh, Shashil Kumar Bishnoi,
Aditya S. Warrior, Siddharth Dhapola,
Karun Garad, Ashish Gangwar,
Homnath Regmi, Nisham Ahmed,
Wasima Hassan, Mohammed Sami,
Sambhav Jain, Kiran Rawat, Dema,
Anil Thapa, George Allen John, Pema Dorji,
Parade Commander, Darpan Ahluwalia, आज के इस ऐतिहासिक दीक्षांत परेड का साक्षी बनने के लिए आप सभी का धन्यवाद। दो पंक्तियों के साथ हम भारतीय पुलिस सेवा के नवयुवा अधिकारियों को शुभकामनाएं देते हैं। सेनानी करो प्रयाण अभय, सारा आकाश तुम्हारा है। सेनानी करो प्रयाण अभय, सारा आकाश तुम्हारा है। ये नखत अमन के बुझते हैं, भावी इतिहास तुम्हारा है। आप सभी को हार्दिक शुभकामनाएं। जय हिंद।
कृष्ण गोपाल मीना, नमित पाठक एंड शिव नारायण शर्मा। थैंक यू ऑल फॉर बीइंग पार्ट ऑफ दिस प्रेस्टिजियस परेड। नाउ बैंड डिस्प्ले इज अबाउट टू स्टार्ट। ऑल द स्पेक्टेटर्स मे काइंडली एंजॉय द शो। नमित पाठक, नमित पाठक एंड शिव नारायण शर्मा। Band display from 12th Battalion Pipe Band Nalgonda has started. Please enjoy the show.